Well, we create a rectangle, suppose some dimension we have. I'm creating a rectangle. Actually, we don't need to create fillet on this wireframe. We can create fillet in the toolpath also. Suppose this is our rectangle. Now first thing we need is machining, and select the machine that you know. Yes. Default. Okay. Now the machine is here, and we can select the contour toolbar. Select the chain. The chain is selected because there is we select the chain. If we deselect the value, see unselect. Yeah. If we click on single, then we can click step by step. Always go in red direction. Yeah, we can change the direction. But at that time, chain is okay because there is some 10 curves. We don't want 10. So deselect that. No, I want to deselect first. No, we don't want 10 now, we need only 4. First unselect the, actually we are clicking 2-3 times on that. Yeah. Actually, sometimes there is some network problem. So first deselect, or we can escape. No. Press no. They said, do you want to keep the no, they said, do you want to keep this toolpath? No problem, we can edit that. No problem. If we go to parameter, there is change geometry. We can select again from here. And we can, now we have to add chain in this. Yeah. Then so click on the curve. Now one chain is there. And now we can change all the parameters. We can give the tool. Suppose we can take 12 mm. There is an option which we are talking, internal corner roughing radius. If we put yeah, the 10 mm radius is automatically generated. Some radius is also here. If we don't want this, just uncheck that. Put some value, na? Then you can put 0 there. Yes. Generate again. Okay. Yeah. There is some radius because we have 12 mm diameter tool. So if we need a sharp edge there, then the tool is moving like that. We can click here and we can see the path. We can increase the speed from there. Yeah. If there is a one quick verification is also there, so that when we run from the start. Now we can see here. Sometimes we don't want this lead in, lead out, so we can cancel it from here. Now the tool is plunging from here. If we open this depth of cut, we change the value of depth of cut, it will ask for how much the step down. This is maximum step, roughing step. Okay, always click keep tool down, so that after one cut tool will move downward, not upward direction. Okay. And in linking parameter we have to put the value how much we want to. Yeah, this value is always in minus. Okay. Because our coordinate system is on at 0 point. After that we can generate. Just right click and click on the top key. We need a stock also, so we can create a rectangle again and we can offset also. There is one offset chain is also available. There is chain. So chain is good. select this object and offset outward. We can offset both sides. Defined side means one side is pink, the preview is there. See, if we reverse that portion, actually by default one side is automatically preview. The preview is there. So if we don't want to this side, then click on opposite side. And we can put the yes sir. Yeah. But if we have some pocket, then the stock will inside. Okay, this is we want to use this pocket like a stock. So what we can do, we can extrude that model. We can extrude this object. We have to change the direction. Now this is our direction. Okay. For extrude, the sketch must be closed. If the sketch is not closed, then nothing will extrude. Okay, after that we can verify from here. Yeah, we have to get, yeah, this is only, no, this is only model. We have to get this from here only. There is the option solid. We can select this arrow. Click on this and select the object. Or we can select Control A also. Okay. If there is option display. If we close this display, then we can't see the stock. If we click solid, then we can see solid. Actually in MasterCAM one little problem is this, when we take stock it will take time to regenerate, refresh, or we can say, yeah, always it take time, some little time. In all MasterCAM this problem is available. Yeah, so now we can verify. Yes, yes. Yes. This is fine. No? Now the time is 1:12. If we click here, there is one option stop. We click once, then it will be transparent. If we one, we can click on two times. Okay, now this is transparent. If we want to see the initial stop, yeah, we can see the initial stop also. Click two times so that we can see transparent. We can see the workpiece also. We can see the toolbar also. If you don't want to see this axis, so we can remove from here. If you don't want to see the wireframe, we can deselect from here. Actually, sometimes by default, by mistake we click somewhere, so we don't understand what happened. If we remove this tool, we can remove the tool also. I think this is the very good option. There is one more option is verify. In verify we can change the color of the toolbar. If we are using two or three colors, then we have to see different toolpath in different colors. So if this option is clicked, then every toolpath is in different color. When we have this model, suppose after cutting, this is the output, na? So we can save this model in STL file. And that model we can open in any software. We can save anywhere. Just create a folder. Now this output file is saved. Now you can go in any software like SolidWorks or some NX or anywhere. At that place you can easily open that. Okay, we can see the section view also. Actually, most of the time, if we have some model like that, then we have to see the section view. If you want to see the right view or left view. We can change the front view also. We can check the 1/4 one. This is the fourth quadrant. Yeah, these are very good options because the main thing is output. If we want to see the output, then we have to know all these options. We can check the distance also. After cutting, what is the distance? Yeah, now this is the distance.
first click is not okay. Yeah, we can change the top view also. Just choose the upper one, this point to point. We can refresh that. After now we already given the stock, na? So we can hide this model. We can hide or we can blank. There is a difference between hide and blank. Blank is hide means select which thing I select, except that everything is blank. Yeah, everything is hide. Okay, and the blank means the option the thing we select will blank. We can unblank and we can unhide also. So we don't want this, so we just hide that. We can hide the stock. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes. No, there is no problem in toolbar. Yeah. Just select this model. when we go in parameters, there is one option more, is stock to leave on walls and stock to leave in floor. If we put some value here, suppose 2 mm, okay, we go into top view, unblank this rectangle. Now the tool we can hide the holder from here, display holder. Now the tool is, yeah, we can reduce little space. Now there is some 2 mm gap is there. That gap is only on walls. Yeah, we can enter the value from here. Yeah. That 2 mm means if we put value minus 10 here, then the tool will go only at minus 8. That 2 mm is reduced from this value. Option left right, we can off the compensation, that is called compensation. Now the tool is running outside the sketch we draw, no? If we off this compensation, yeah, change the direction. Yeah, now the tool is go inside the boundary. One very important option is there. Suppose we don't unblank anything. Okay, something like that. So now what we can do, just click on this. Only display selected toolbar. One. And this one more option, only display selected associate geometry. If we click on that, the geometry used for this toolpath, that only we can see. That will automatically hide all the things except the wireframe we used in this toolpath. Yeah, everything everything is hide except the geometry used in this toolpath. So always select these two options.
see, there is some yellow color line. Yeah, this is retract. So what we can do, we can hide these retract also. That is very dangerous if we hide this. So always on this option so that we can see where the tool is moving. But sometime like me, when we create a video on YouTube, for thumbnail we hide this so that people think everything is going in rapid or the linear motion. We can hide the this. But that is not good for in industry, because all we want to see how much tool is going into the air and how much time it will travel in air, so that we can actually, the main difference between the this time, the time we calculated here and verify, and this time is exact, yeah, but more retrack is there. That will affect on this time. If a lot of retracks are there or rapid moves are there, then the actual time and this time may be some difference. Always on this, we can hide this tool path from here. If we click here, then the tool path is hide. When we want to see, then we can open that. So you can see the green tick is there. Yeah. No, that is not okay. If that is selected, yeah, if toolpath is okay, then there is some value and no red cross is there. If some problem is there, then there is a red cross. So we have to generate, we can say regenerate all selected operation, or we can generate only all dirty operation. That means if we change some parameter, suppose we change this value, then there is a cross. That means this is dirty operation. If we have 7 toolpaths there and we don't want to regenerate all, then we can click on this. Okay, that means only dirty operation will regenerate. If any toolpath is okay, then that will no, there is no change in, on that. Okay. Because now we have one toolpath, that means it doesn't matter which one we selected. No? Yeah, this is for G-code. But before G-code, we have to click on this copy image. That copy image, we can select any area. Press escape to select entire screen. So I am clicking on press escape. Now we can paste anywhere. And Microsoft Word also. That is very helpful. Yeah, we can take print out of here. After that we can take post process that. can save anywhere. Always choose a good location so that we can see the code from this code export, and we can change also. If we want to change something, then we can change from here. This is the toolbar. We can edit this toolpath according to our requirement, but that we will do later. Otherwise we lost our topic. So after that we can see. We can use this contour toolpath as a 3D toolpath, and we can also use as a rotary toolpath. Okay, we will do all step by step. If we choose a taper valve from here, see there is some taper. And we can, if we put value 12 mm here, this is degree. Now see, there is some taper. Some steps are there. Yes, yes. Yeah. Yes. Generated first. That is it for me. If we have pocket, then we can change the direction. If we have boss, then we can change accordingly. One more option is very good. See, this is, there is option end points. If we click on that, then the points will blink automatically. If we have overlapped line, actually sometimes we have lines like that, and if we close this endpoint, we can't understand where is the duplicate lines. And when we choose geometry like chain, then there is a problem. Because at that point it can't understand which chain we have to choose, the this one or this one. Yeah, so if we have this, then we can see easily. One more option is there. There is option run add-in. Here one option is find overlap. See, this is find overlap. Yes, if we click on that press Control A and selection. See, now it automatically highlight that portion. If we want to clean up, then just click on this clean up. One overlap entity deleted. This line is deleted now. That is very easy. And most of the persons, they don't know about this option. This is very important thing, because in industry, if you want to learn something from anyone, you know what we can teach them, so that they will help us. That is the option. We can tell anyone. Okay, find over. Now there is no overlap, so let's see what they ask. See, now there is one overlap. Yeah. Just select next and click on. Oh, sorry. We have to click on the clean button. One very good option is there. Hello. After creating the toolpath, suppose we are thinking some fillet need there. Normal fillet, and we can change some values. Okay, click on trim entity. Hello. Yes, yes. I think some connection lost. Actually, when I click on this, the toolpath, see, now the toolpath is broken. The fillet is gone because we select this one. Huh? We can select again. What we can do, just click on geometry, rechain all, and click here. And after that, we can rechain. That is not required.
let me check again. We have to change now. No problem. We can select regenerate, regen all. Select the curve. First close this. Then region. So region. I'm doing it again. So last time, and this is option is closed. Now we can go to kind of create a radius and region. See, now there is no problem. Now we don't need to chain again, but we can do it. See, just create a fillet. Okay, we can change the radius. After that, regenerate it. Just because now this option is closed, so it will take automatically. Yeah. After that, we can select this. That means if you want to edit the toolpath or edit the chain, then this option must be closed. So that you can easily change the suppose we can once again we can do create a circle, close this option. If you want to trim this sketch, then there is option divide. Is option divide. In 2020 or 2019 this divide option is not available here. That will come outside. Okay, now this option is in between this. So what we can do, we can divide that. But our stock is out, our this curve is out of the stock, so we have to change that stock first. We can select the rectangular, and we can select also select the boundary box. So when we click on this, just press Ctrl A and selection and put some Z value here. We need in minus. No minus value is there. No need, just press 0 here. Click OK. And put the value here. value is always in positive. No, no, that will not take in minus. The stock will never go in minus. It will always. We can change this origin. We can change the origin, but we can't put minus value here. We can put value minus x in value in x and y, but we can't put value in minus in z. I think that is sufficient for today. You practice on this, all the options. That is very good if you write down these all options, so that after 20 days we have something to recall the things. If you write down somewhere, then today is today you can write, but after 20 days you can't remember which options we have done or which we so if we do step by step daily, then that will very helpful for you. If you think after 1 week I will write, then there is nothing to actually today one person in Bangalore he is doing power mill. And I just asked them, just mirror this toolpath. He said that toolpath. I don't know how to mirror. I said we already done. But he asked, no, we can't do. I don't know how to do. So that is why I am asking. If you write down somewhere what options we do, then after 20 days that will be very helpful for you. Okay, that is fine. I will send you.